The Bavarian Alps last weekend rounded off a momentous four-month season for 33-year-old former London decathlete Nick Phipps. Phipps walks the 1,200-metre mountainside track, mentally preparing himself for the coming two-man event. Already behind him this season, Britain's first win in a major championship since the days of Nash and Dixon, when Nick and brakeman Alan Kearns won the World Cup event at Cortina last December and also set a track record at Chivinia in Italy. At Koningsee, Phipps and Kearns will be touching speeds of up to 70 miles an hour.
The problem is, if you get the Kreisel, this is the big omega curve here, wrong, you come in a little bit late into this little S combination. And then it makes you very late for a curve which is called Kerfstein, which is quite a tricky corner. So you want to be in there nice and in the middle and going straight. So you have to really concentrate very hard on this particular point.
An explosive event such as bobsleighing needs extremely fit competitors. Both Alan Kearns and Nick Phipps are former track athletes of distinction. Phipps has the responsibility of steering, but what is Alan Kearns' role as brakeman?
In the two-man, first and foremost is the start. It's essential to have a fast start and then to keep that momentum from the start. And then at the very end of the run, obviously, to brake. But in between, there's a lot of teamwork. Although you don't actually move around in the sled, you do put pressure on certain runners, especially on slow parts of the track. If on a right-hand bend, a slow right-hand bend, I put pressure on the bottom runner, then we tend to drive more smoothly and obviously gather more speed. At Cortina, that was essential, and we did quite well there with the teamwork.
That was the World Cup. This is the World Championship.
Most of the sleds come out of Italy, a place called Cortina, where there's a small blacksmith makes these sleds. They're very good, basically, the chassis and the suspension on it. But really the key thing is the aerodynamics. And this is something we've been missing out on. We need to look into and develop our sleds a little bit more. Both the runners move side to side. You have a spring leaf suspension. And you have ropes suspended on a D-rope underneath the cowling, in which I hold on to. And with ropes, you get a lot more feeling through your hands. It's maybe like flying. You feel through your teeth and feel through your hands. And it's a lot better than, say, a steering wheel.
The International Bobsleigh Federation has got very strict rules about the runners. What kind of parameters have you got?
It's mostly on the width size. It has to be 4 millimetres wide. Obviously, if the runners are a lot thinner, they're a lot faster on the ice. And we have to really look after that fact. We have a special gauge in which we check that they're the right thickness before we race. And if you're over, you're out. Simple as that. Heat as well.
Heat, is that important?
Yes, it's got to be plus or minus the air temperature, the runners. If they're hot, then, of course, you're out again. And hot runners are very good, very fast, because they're melting the ice and you're running on more water.
How much care do you take of your runners?
Well, we treat them like babies, really. You must, they rust very, very quickly. So as soon as we come in from the cold, We rub them down and put them on the radiators. And most hotels hate bobsleighs because they take the whole space up with runners.
Looking at the bobsleigh scene, it seems that you all get on very well, the various countries. There doesn't seem to be the kind of needle that you get in other sports.
No, that's right. I think over the last few years, especially as we've been doing a lot better, we had a great patch in the 60s with Nash and Dixon, and they were highly respected. And I think we're getting some of that back a little bit now. They know we're not messing about, we're now serious.
Phipps and Cairns, together with the other members of the Great Britain team, work out daily in a local gymnasium.
Eight, nine, ten.
Back at the hotel, two apprentices from Allied Steel and Wire of Cardiff, the British number one team's sponsors, are working on the all-important runners. With 0.04 of a second possibly separating the top three teams, hours of elbow grease and rubbing down with emery paper goes into giving the face of the runners a mirror-like finish. Phipps is suffering from flu, and Cairns hasn't fully recovered from a painful neck injury as they wait at the top of the hill for the start.
The Swiss number one bob, Pickler and Poulterer. Been around quite a while, this 30-year-old Swiss driver. 13 years on the circuit, although he's only 30. World two-man champion. And the start so critical. Away they go. Oh, tremendously fast start time. Tremendously fast. No one's been near that. And Pickler driving well. Good line. And that's quick too. 21:46. Good ride this by the Swiss number one, Bob. Middle of the track until he has to ride the banks. That too is quick. 36:46. This is going to be very, very fast indeed. So the chute is improving. Oh, and look at that finish time. A new track record. Nobody's been near that. 49:65 to Pickler and Poulterer for the Swiss number one team. Well, now we're bound to see a jump in standards and a change of tradition from the elite to some newcomers. This is an Australian pair. Adrian Di Piazza, the driver. Nick Fuchs, a new number two man for him. But Adrian Di Piazza really has started his own Australian Federation for when he went back home, he found there wasn't one. So he's borrowed a bob from the International Federation, and he's got a team together, and he's gaining experience all the time. But this really is his first season in the sport. Living in a trailer, learning from the Europeans, this is what it's about for the Australians, and these times are bound to be slow by comparison. 22:51. Well, the Australians have done it in skiing in the past, and they're now trying to make a name for themselves in bobbing.
38:60.
And driving well, getting a lot of support from the Europeans. And I don't think they're going to be too disappointed. So look out for Adrian Di Piazza and Nick Fuchs. Nick Fuchs to Nick Phipps with Alan Cairns. Both a little bit under the weather, but they too gaining experience all the time. Alan Cairns, the sprinter. Nick Phipps, the decathlete.
Two, three.
And the sprint, absolutely vital. Absolutely vital. Keeping going, Alan Cairns, as long as possible before he ducks down to the bob. A little bit disappointing, seventh fastest. High on the wall. High again.
How's it?
but rattling around a bit here, and that won't help him. Slowed it just a little. Bouncing off the walls a bit. Next split time, only 11th, so it's not one of their better runs. And I think Nick Phipps might be a little disappointed with this one.
After their first run, Great Britain are in 14th place, well behind the favourites East Germany. But with Phipps feeling better, he and Cairns improved their position to 11th with one run to go.
Chance to see Pickler and Poulter again, second overall. They're the track record holders. Brilliant first run. But the snow is falling a bit now. May have slowed this course down. Tremendous run by Poulterer. Third fastest on this run at the start time. And of course, the Swiss vying with one another. They call themselves Swiss number one, but they've still got Swiss very good bobs to come. And they've got the reigning world champions to follow too. They've improved. So Pickler is driving well. And lost a little bit there. Lost just a little. But still up within range of the medals. A lot of following here from Switzerland on this Königssee course in West Germany in Berchtesgaden. But look at that. They've dragged it back again. 3:22:20 total time. 51:26 their run. But now for the reigning world champions and Olympic champions. DDR1, Wolfgang Hopper and Dietmar Schauerhammer. Two great athletes drawn together. They lead overall, and anything like a decent run here means the gold is theirs. Now, that's only the second fastest time because the Soviet two-man team had a very, very quick start and then lost it. But Hopper has seen what Pickler has done on this course now that a little bit of snow is falling. And if he can keep within touch of that, and he is, yes he is, 21:81, he's faster than the Swiss one. This is the fifth year that Hopper has been driving, and he's been pretty well untouchable. And he's going well. Superb aerodynamic bob, and again they've done enough. 51:13, it's faster than the Swiss number one, and that's another great victory. No wonder they're delighted. Little anxiety in the British camp, Nick Phipps and Alan Cairns. Everybody helping them on their way. And Cairns keeping the sprinting going as long as he dare. Well, disappointing when you compare them with the East Germans and the Swiss. And again, he's riding from side to side. Every knock is bound to detract from a fast time. And it isn't getting better. Took that bend well. And this 1,200 meter chute behaving well.
How'd it go, Nick?
Not too bad. Quite a good, probably one of my best runs, I think. I don't know what the time was yet.
How are you feeling personally? Because you've had flu for the best part of 3 days.
A little weak still, but not too bad. Certainly this run I felt the best so far. Probably finished.
How do you think you've done in this particular two-man?
Well,
as well as you thought?
No, not as well. I think yesterday really sort of messed us up, not feeling too good. But I hope if we stay in the top 11 or 12, I'll be happy and ready for the four-man.
Phipps and Cairns did in fact finish in 12th place. Now their attention turns to the four-man event the following weekend. The other two members of the team, Keith Power and Bob Thorne, have been sent off on a secret trip to Zurich to pick up a Swiss sledge which has been loaned to them for the four-man World Championships. Its arrival noticeably lifts the spirits of Nick and Alan, who felt they hadn't done themselves justice in the two-man event. 19-year-old Power, who would normally be in the middle of the bob, has had to withdraw after breaking two fingers at an earlier meeting. And this has disrupted the rhythm and planning of the team in their quest for the gold medal.
Okay, someone get the other side.
After winning an overall bronze in the World Cup Series, this borrowed four-man bob here at Königssee may be enough to get the Great Britain One team into medal contention.
The thing is with this, it's so beautifully balanced. The whole weight of the sled is on the underneath side, right down low. So you've got a lot of weight and pressure on the runners. And also the beautiful aerodynamics on the sled is really helps.
Nobody yet knows that you've managed to get this bob. How did you come by it?
Fortunately, we've got a Swiss coach called John Caviezza who's helped us a lot this year. And he got talking to Egerhard Fasser and got the sled for us.
Presumably, when the others find out, they're going to be a bit shocked, aren't they?
I think so, yeah. I hope we can have a cover and just sort of unwheel it on the first day of training. And I think there'll be quite a few surprises.
So the first run already. The crew, Nick Phipps, Alan Cairns, Bob Thorne and Lenny Paul. And that's an interesting brakeman coming in. Lenny Paul is the Army Sprint Champion, a 27-year-old PT instructor from Ipswich. Bob Thorne, well, he's in his third season, so he's gaining experience. But what they've got to do is learn to live together in this new bob. The start's so critical. Now, can Lenny Paul's sprinting speed add to their start time? There it is. Eighth fastest, but everything judged in hundredths and tenths of seconds, of course. This is where they need to keep to the middle of the road. And they're banging about just a little bit. No question about it, Nick is delighted with the new bob. 36.53, their second split time. Up to the finish now. 49.69.
After the first round, Great Britain won our joint 12th, but they improved to 10th position going into the fourth and final run.
Now for the Great Britain 2 bob. They're using Nick Phipps' actual bob. Tom De La Hunt in the driver, of course, who's had a lot of experience. John Edwards with him. And that's Mark Tout in 3, replacing Neil Coyne, who's also been under the weather. And David Armstrong, the brakeman. Good team spirit. The interchanging, the building up of the best possible four is something the whole team are anxious to do. So Tom De La Hunt gets them underway. That's a good start time. Third out of 13. Now, can he hold a good line? Going well. Wandering a little on that banking. Gaining speed now. Oh, and they've hit the side. Watch the flurry of snow. They've certainly taken it too high. And Tom De La Hunty got knocked about there, I'm sure. Very high on the bank. Still holding on. and he's safely taken them over the line, and a fast time, but I'm sure they took a bang high on the right-hand side of the banking. Great flurry of snow that came up. And that's always a sign. Watch it here. He's off his runners, hits the wall, there's the snow, but gets it back on course. And indeed, having checked him out, delighted to say Tom is okay. Well now, five times the world champion, Eric Schara, 39. After this, he says he retires. He's got his crack squad with him. A lot of dissent in the Swiss camp this season about who's going to drive which bob, who's going to ride with them. Eric Schara, who's dominated the four-man bob like Hoppy has dominated the two-man bob. And really, they've had such tremendous runs that this could be a fifth world championship for the greatest driver in the world. Brilliantly smooth. Schara fairly hurtling down. And look at that. Number one against his times. He really is roaring along. Schara, Meyer, Fassbind and Kisa. Will it be the perfect retirement? Yes, it will be for Eric Schara, 39. He's done it again. The man himself. Now Nick Phipps, Alan Cairns, Bob Thorne and Lenny Paul. Still getting used to this new bob. Kaziatsa, their team coach, says they're only scratching their potential so far. They've got a long way to go. But that's not too good a start time. A couple of tenths lost there. But I'm sure they feel they've had enough overall success this season to really train in the off-season and to make next season count for them. Their success in World Cup, relative success in European Championships. The best we've seen since the 60s. And they've improved a little there. Going better. Up to the finish, and they've improved on that run.
In fact, a rather disappointing 10th place overall. But what does the future hold for Nick Phipps and his team?
I think over the next couple of years, with a couple more years' experience, a few more runs under my belt, plus we get these sleds sorted out, I think we've got a good chance in the 88 Olympics.
And the reporters for that story were Peter Walker and Ron Pickering. Now, we'll have all the football information for you in just a couple of minutes' time, so don't go away. But we're going to stay with winter sport, because I know so many of you like that too. All the World Cup skiers have moved from Europe.